today we are going to cover the very important topic, that is professional etiquettes. So professional etiquettes, profession means when you are working somewhere, and etiquette means mannerisms. So professional etiquettes, if you join together, means the manners, the mannerisms, the etiquettes that you need to follow when you are working in a working environment, in an organization or in a corporate. So as you all know that you all are here enrolled for different professional courses, and you all are aspirants to join one or the other corporate, or you might end up, you know, starting your own startup or being an entrepreneur. In both the cases, we all need professional etiquettes. So the socially acceptable set of rules that we need to follow while we are working in a working environment or organization is what we can term as professional etiquettes. Now the question arises is, why do we need professional etiquettes? To stand out from the crowd, to make a mark of our own, to be confident, to make a very positive impression on the others is why we use professional etiquettes. We all know that first impression is the last impression, and if we are exhibiting professional etiquettes, it's going to be a lasting impression. So let's start with different ways or different set of platforms where we have to exhibit our professional etiquettes. Number one, foremost important is email etiquettes. You know, whenever we are communicating within an organization, or even if you take an example of your college itself, university itself, you get a lot of information on your WhatsApp groups. But is that something which is formal? No. So whenever you are receiving an email for the same, giving the same information, it becomes formal. So within an organization, when we have to work, we have to communicate using different platforms, and that all are on email etiquettes. So we must know how to email somebody in the within the organization or outside the organization. Number one very important point when we start with emailing somebody is to whom this email is addressed to. It is very important that we make it sure that we are sending the email to the right person. Number two, most important is the subject line. If the subject line is not appropriate according to the email that we are sending, it's going to land up in trash, or the receiver might not take even note of that. So it's very important that the subject line should be very precise and clear. Next is, whenever you are writing an email, what is the tone of that email? It has to be very respectful, even if it is a complaint email or a warning letter. In any case, the tone of the email has to be very respectful, because we are working in an environment where we need to show respect to each and every other person. So very important, use or follow a respectful tone throughout your communication. Next important is proofread. Before you are sending your email ultimately to the receiver, it is very important that you at least proofread twice. Check for the grammatical mistakes, sentence corrections, then check for the attachments that you are going to attach along with your email in case you have any, and make it sure that you are sending the correct attachment with the email. Once everything has been checked, only then you should click on the send button of the email. This is about email etiquettes. Number second is telephonic etiquettes. So we all know that when we are working in an organization, it's not always going to be like a face-to-face interaction. So many times we have to communicate, we have to work on phone or telephonically or mobile phones. So what are the basic etiquettes that we need to follow while we are communicating on mobile phone or telephone? So the first point, which is very important, is that you must identify yourself before, at the beginning of the talk. Why? Because the other person should know to whom he is addressed to. So very important, you must identify yourself. Number second, speak clearly and slowly. It is very important that if you want the other person should understand whatever you are communicating, you must make it very clear. Clear and concise communication is what is required here. Number next, very important is that you should avoid any kind of interruption or disruption while you are working or while you are making your communication through telephone. So very important, make sure that there is no disturbance when you are talking to somebody on phone. Number next, very important again, is how you are communicating. What is the tone, right? Are you listening to the other person clearly? So be an active listener. Try to understand what the other person from the other side is trying to communicate. Because if you are not attentive, you might end up asking every next time, "Pardon, sir, what do you say? Can you please repeat?" That is not going to make a good impression on the other person. So next comes meeting etiquettes. When we are working in an environment, in a corporate, we need to go and attend certain meetings. We might have to present certain presentations. For that, there are few etiquettes that we need to follow. Number one is always be on time. But I suggest that you should be before time at the venue where the meeting is going to be held. It is going to make you more confident, you are more relaxed, you are pious, you know what I have to do. So very important, be on time. Number second is you should know what is the agenda of the meeting. Because if you don't know what is the agenda, how will you prepare for the meeting? So very important, have a clarity on the agenda of the meeting and prepare accordingly. Next very important is that you must keep your mobile phone or silent mode or airplane mode, or you can switch it off. Because if the phone rings up within the meeting, it's definitely going to make a wrong impression of yours on others. Very important, right? Next is that you have to be very precise and your communication has to be relevant to the agenda that is being taken up in the meeting. Take care of all these points. You're definitely going to, you know, make a good impression in the meetings that you're going to be a part of. Next important is our cubicle etiquettes. This means when we are working in an environment in corporate, there are different cubicles, workstations where we will be sitting. So just next to us, other person's workspace will be there. So we need to know how to behave while we are in our workstation. Whenever we have to go to the other person, we have to communicate. It's very important that we ask for the permission. We knock the door or ask for the permission. Only then we can enter their cubicle. Number second is please avoid eating in your own workspace. Why? Because you know the smell of the food that you are eating might not be liked by the other person, or it's not actually well manners if we are eating something at our workplace. So please avoid. Next is that if you are just roaming around here and there and peeping inside the other cubicles, that is again very wrong. Please do not do that. It's going to ruin your impression on others. Next, be very respectful and courteous to the other person who is sitting in the next cubicle. Do not speak on the speaker phone. It's going to definitely disrupt or interrupt the other person who might be very busy on his own work. So please follow these instructions, these mannerisms while you're working in an organization while sitting in a cubicle. So these are very important points that we need to take care of while we are working in an environment so that we know where to start and where to end. This means our journey towards a success is depending on all of the etiquettes that we are exhibiting while we are in the professional world. So I am sure that with all these points, along with them, there's a very important point that is of your dressing etiquettes. You all know that we always put so much of stress and so much of, we are always after you that you have to be in a formal attire because we want you to look professional. So very important, formal attire. When you are working in an organization, you must always adhere to a strict formal attire. You must know how to groom yourself. You must look good. You must look confident. Your body language should exhibit positive attitude. Very important. For being a team player, for you to be a part of any team, it's very important that you are always positive, always up to work for something, always courteous, saying thank you wherever it's required, and always exhibiting the proper mannerisms which are required in any professional world. If you follow all of these etiquettes, your journey towards success within the organization, nobody can stop you from gaining the best position in the organization. All the best and wish you all the luck. Thank you.